So as you guys know, I have made a ton of YouTube videos all revolving around my aquatic animals. But what I haven't done is taken each aquarium and gone super in depth on the equipment I use in that tank and the livestock. So I thought today I would take the time to pick out one of my favorite aquariums, which is my 36 gallon freshwater planted aquarium. And I'm gonna give you a full walkthrough top to bottom of the equipment, the fish, the plants, everything I use to keep this aquarium clean, running. I'm gonna talk about the fish food I use, and of course all my habitats in this tank. So I thought today would be the perfect day to go ahead and go in depth on this aquarium. Now if you like this style of video where I'm just sitting here talking and showing you the aquarium, go ahead and drop a like on this. If you like this style, that will let me know I need to make more of these, and comment down below what other tanks I should make this style of video on. Without further ado, here is the top of the aquarium. So this is a 36 gallon corner aquarium, meaning it was designed to perfectly fit in a corner. As you can see, it has this radius front and then two perfect sides that lead right into that corner. A very odd style of tank, and I really haven't seen too many of them. Up here, I keep my fish food. This is by Reef Nutrition. It's their TDO micro pellets, and it feeds all my tropical fish in this tank, and they love it. Back here is the lid. Now, this is a little triangle cutout that kind of keeps fish from jumping out because this is not a normal aquarium, so you can't have a normal lid. We have some pothos leaves right here, which are just stuck in there to help grow, to see if they would even grow, to be honest with you. And then we have our canister filter hoses, which we'll get to later. The rest of the lid is just covered with this little glass lid. It came with the aquarium when I bought it. And then right up here is my current USA Satellite Plus Pro LED light. This is what keeps the plants happy and healthy in the aquarium. It's set up on a timer, and it has been working great for this aquarium. Now before we talk about the fish and everything, let's talk about the stand. So obviously the stand was made for the tank, has some shelves right here, and then a cabinet, which is so messy and just disgusting. Ignore all that. But back there we have the Fluval 305, which is the canister filter that runs this aquarium. Moving into the tank, you can see that is the canister filter outtake, and then that is the intake right there. The other equipment on this tank is the heater. That is a Eheim Jaeger 100 watt aquarium heater, and this tank runs at around 75 degrees. By the way, those blue LED lights you see, they're not actually part of the tank. They're just behind the tank. You can ignore them. Now we can go ahead and move on to the inside of the tank. Now, as you can see, this is a planted aquarium. However, it is very, very low tech. Starting from the bottom, we actually have Carib Sea's basically planted aquarium substrate. It has the necessary nutrients needed to keep a successful planted aquarium. So it's really nothing special. It's just basic planted aquarium substrate, and it is in that nice black gravel color. We have this large piece of driftwood in the middle. I actually ordered this off Amazon. It was like $17 and it was just a large piece of driftwood, and it turned out really nice. Buying it from Amazon, I did not know what it was gonna look like. It was kind of buying sight unseen, but I think it actually turned out really nice and it looks awesome in this tank. As for rocks, I have two different types of stones. I believe the darker one is Dragonstone, and I'm not quite sure exactly the name of the gray one. However, these are both by Carib Sea, and they are Carib Sea's rocks. I really like them in this aquarium. I think they look good. They really add to that natural look of the aquarium. Moving on to plants, the first thing I have is a moss ball. Now, this tank is full of Anubias. As you can see, I believe there's like four Anubias plants. We have this huge one right here, which has just totally sprouted and just grown everywhere. We have a tiny little crypt plant, I believe, right there. And then more Anubias back there, and a little bit of what I believe is Java Fern Windelove. Moving up right next to the driftwood, I believe that is more Java Fern Windelove. I'm not quite sure if that's the correct name. I feel like it is. That could also be wrong. Moving over here, more Anubias. And then we have crypt right here. I'm not sure the name or the type of crypt. I just know it's a crypt plant. So we have some down here, and then this big one right here. These guys are pretty slow growers, but as you can see, I've had them in the tank a while and they're just growing a ton. I also have a little bit of Java moss just kind of spread throughout. It's hard for you to see, but it is there. And then the last plant is this large Anubias right here, growing almost all the way to the top of the tank. Now, as I mentioned, this plant tank is super low maintenance. I probably need to spend some time trimming up the plants. However, I really just let it grow, and I thought it was better to kind of show you the tank in its natural state, just to show you really what it looks like. Actually, I lied, we have one more plant, and that is duckweed floating on the surface. Moving into fish, we have quite a few. As you can see, these are some platies. These I actually bred in another aquarium, and we just have a whole bunch of them in here. I'm not quite sure how many because it's way too hard to count, but we have a whole bunch of small orange and black platies. We also have this blue gourami right here. I actually got this guy from Walmart a few years back when Walmart sold fish. We have a koi angelfish right here on the right. I also have two more angelfish in this aquarium. There's one in the back, and both of the other angelfish have that kind of silvery color with that black stripe, or the black stripes, I should say. We have one blue glowfish danio, as well as a whole bunch of guppies. Female, male, we just have a whole bunch of colorful, fancy guppies. It's hard for you to really pick up on them just because they move so quickly, but there's a couple. I also have one white skirt tetra who I've had in here for almost 5 years. That is the longest fish I've ever had. I believe the oldest fish I've ever had besides some of my goldfish, which are in the koi pond. But there's that little lone white skirt tetra who's doing awesome and just still kicking it. There is a Siamese algae eater right there. I have a black neon tetra who you can't see because he's over the side right there, black neon. There's also an albino bristlenose pleco who likes to chill on this wood right here, but he is hiding at the moment. And then my last fish is my glowfish shark. This is a purple rainbow shark, and I've had him for about 3 years, and I got him when he first came out. And just like that, that is a wrap for my 36-gallon corner aquarium. So if you guys do like this style of video, don't forget to let me know down in the comments. Maybe we can make this a weekly thing if you guys enjoy it, and I can do it to all of my aquariums eventually. And also don't forget to leave this video a nice thumbs up to let me know you guys like the aquarium. If you have any questions or comments, don't forget to leave them down below and I will try my best to answer all of them. Once again, thank you guys so much for watching and goodbye.